Thanks for joining us for CBN News Midday. I'm Lori Johnson.
And I'm Mark Martin. Topping our news, lawmakers say that airports are still not secure enough. Alarming new findings from a congressional report show there have been more than 25,000 security breaches in the past 10 years.
Billions of dollars have been spent on increased airport security since 9/11. But lawmakers say tens of thousands of security breaches still happen.
Security breaches in the thousands, all these many years after 9/11, should concern the American people.
Of the 25,000 breaches, more than 14,000 people were able to access sensitive areas of the airport. And about 6,000 passengers with carry-on luggage were able to make it past a checkpoint without proper screening. TSA officials say the data is misleading. They say thousands of breaches reported still represent only a fraction of 1% of the travelers who have been screened. In a statement, they went on to say, quote, many of these instances were thwarted or discovered in the act. Airports today are safer than ever before.
Certainly, it's a small percentage given the large number of people screened. On the other hand, we know from hard experience, 9/11, that only one security breach can be catastrophically fatal.
Only last week, a cleaning crew on a JetBlue plane found a stun gun that made it past security. And in June, a Nigerian man made it across the country using a stolen ID and an old boarding pass.
We could have the best technology, you could have the best processes and plans, but it's, again, it comes down to the human factor and human error.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Lawmakers are holding a congressional hearing today to discuss the TSA breaches, and they will also review Department of Homeland Security documents on travel after 9/11.
The president and congressional leaders are trying again today to break the stalemate in the talks on the debt ceiling. But the Senate Republican leader has proposed a backup plan just in case. Senator Mitch McConnell's plan would raise the nation's credit limit without Republicans having to vote for it. It would basically give the president authority to raise the debt ceiling. The House and Senate could only stop him if they had veto-proof majorities. McConnell emphasized that his idea is just a last resort.
This is, again, not my first choice. I would advocate that we pass legislation giving the president the authority to request of us an increase in the debt ceiling that would take us past the end of his term.
McConnell's plan immediately ran into opposition from Tea Party conservatives.
The media is pressing Michelle Bachmann to comment on undercover video of a gay man allegedly seeking help from her husband's Christian counseling center. The question is whether or not Dr. Marcus Bachmann's clinic works to help gay people turn straight. The media says he claims the clinic doesn't practice reparative therapy. However, gay advocates say their video proves otherwise. Michelle Bachmann has not commented on the allegations. Many media reports on the Bachmann Clinic are agreeing with the homosexual activists who suggest that it's impossible to change a person's sexual orientation. The reports also suggest that the American Psychological Association has denounced any therapeutic efforts to help those who want to change. As Heather Sells reports, neither statement is true.
If you've watched the mainstream media's reporting in the last day or so, you've seen these tapes, which suggest that changing sexual orientation is not possible. In fact, at least one major study shows change is possible. Psychologist Mark Yarhouse explored the question in a six-year work that he presented at the American Psychological Association's annual conference.
I think our study raises that question again. It says, well, wait a minute, here's a change effort sustained over time, and there's a pretty significant percentage of people for whom this was helpful.
Yarhouse and co-author Stan Jones followed 63 people who tried to change with the help of Christian ministries. 30% were able to reduce their homosexual attraction enough to be celibate without distress. And another 23% were able to convert to opposite sex attraction. Total that changed 53%, although Yarhouse admits it's tough.
And our study shouldn't be taken to mean that anybody can change or that everybody can change. It does look like it's difficult.
Some mainstream media are reporting that the American Psychological Association, or APA, has rejected so-called conversion therapy. But that's just not true. The APA has not banned it or even deemed it unethical. However, its latest statement does raise concerns. A 2009 task force report says efforts to change sexual orientation are unlikely to be successful and involve some risk of harm. Still, the APA notes that for some, sexual orientation identity is fluid, perhaps an open door for more research on this controversial subject. Heather Sell, CBN News.
David Brody has more on the media's coverage of this issue. You can find it at the Brody File on CBNNews.com.
President Obama and the Democratic National Committee have raised more than $86 million for his reelection campaign. That's $26 million more than they planned to raise, according to campaign manager Jim Messina. Obama launched his campaign in April with the goal of raising $60 million. Republican candidates have raised only about $35 million so far.
Opening statements begin today in the trial of baseball star Roger Clemens. He's accused of lying to Congress about his use of steroids. Clemens was indicted last August on charges of obstruction of Congress, perjury, and giving false statements. He denied using performance-enhancing drugs, specifically steroids and human growth hormones. Clemens maintains that he did not use any kind of drug during a 24-season career.
A new community garden is coming to the town of Castle Rock, Washington, but it won't be growing tomatoes or corn. It'll be growing marijuana. Medical marijuana gardens become legal in the state of Washington next week. Now, the town of Castle Rock is divided over a new garden designated just for that purpose.
Little old Castle Rock, sometimes the little towns are the ones that do the weirdest things.
I don't know if I'm for it or against it.
The new law requires the marijuana garden to abide by strict guidelines. The garden cannot be visible from anywhere in a public setting. It must have a locked fence around it, and it can have a maximum of 45 plants growing. That's expected that marijuana from this garden will help treat about 10 patients.
A brutal heat wave is blasting half of the country, including much of the South, Midwest, and the East Coast. Temperatures are soaring above 100 degrees in 15 states. The heat has been so bad, more than 36 people have died. Charlene Israel has the story.
With triple-digit temperatures in many places, the heat has turned deadly. In Jackson, Mississippi, this 61-year-old pastor died from heat exhaustion after working in his yard.
You live in heat stroke, you quit sweating. Not in all cases, but most cases, you quit sweating and just get extremely hot because your body's not losing the ability to fight off the heat at that point.
Heat advisories are in effect for nearly half the country, including Alabama, Kansas, and Arkansas. In Denning, Arkansas, survivors of a tornado a few months ago are riding out the extreme heat in tents.
You feel weak, you're weak, and you feel like you're going to black out, and you go to your knees, and you just hope that somebody pays attention and gets you to the emergency room.
The hot weather is adding to already serious drought conditions in parts of the country. In addition to the stifling heat in the Midwest, storm winds gusted up to 85 miles an hour, killing at least one person, injuring six. In parts of Manhattan, the strain in the electrical grid knocked out power. The power company is urging customers to save energy. Many cities have opened cooling stations to help residents cool off.
Keeping hydrated and sunblock.
Meanwhile, those who work outside are trying to stay cool too.
This hat helps a lot too. Keeps the sun off the top of your head.
Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Legal action against the Department of Veterans Affairs is going forward.
It's over claims that an official has banned the mention of God at Houston's VA cemetery. Dale Hurd has the story.
A court hearing is scheduled for next week in the suit of three veterans groups against the Department of Veterans Affairs and the director of the Houston National Cemetery, Arlene Ocasio, for religious hostility and unlawful censorship. This after the Houston National Cemetery banned the mention of God at funerals for vets. Nobleton Jones is a member of the VFW Honor Guard at the Houston VA Cemetery, told by Ocasio to stop mentioning God.
On March the 15th, she said that I could not say that the District Court Ceremony Jail, I could not say we wish you and your family, that God meant you and your family, grace, mercy, and peace. And that makes me feel smaller, even after I spent my time in the military, being able to fight for that right so that they would be able to say that.
The Department of Veterans Affairs has issued a statement saying the name of God or Jesus is not only allowed, it is freely spoken at VA national cemeteries across the country. And the VA repeated the substance of that claim in a letter to Texas Senator Kay Bailey Hutchison, obtained by CBN News. But the Liberty Institute's lead counsel, Kelly Shackelford, says the VA's denial contradicts what happened when the VA was first approached about the ban on the mention of God at Houston National Cemetery.
We sent a letter to the VA administration. We said, look, here's what's happened. This is a violation of the law. This went all the way to the highest, to their general counsel, who said, we're not changing our position. So really left us with no choice. And the judge issued a very strong restraining order, the federal judge, saying the government cannot tell somebody how to pray.
And all we're asking is that the government make things right for us.
The Liberty Institute has set up a new website for support and donations called DontTearUsDown.com. Houston National Cemetery Director Arlene Ocasio did not return our call requesting a comment. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Coming up, walking the coast of Israel, what one man discovered on his journey through the Holy Land.
Have you ever had an idea for an invention or new product? Bill Schaefer, one of the inventors of Wham-O's new Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play one hot summer afternoon. Bill invented a car wash for kids. Ride through it, run through it. And Ben helped submitted the Splash Wash to Wham-O, the makers of childhood favorites like the Frisbee, Hula Hoop, and Slip and Slide. If you have an invention you would like to try to patent and submit to corporations and want free information that explains how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest invention company with sales offices in over 50 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain on the Splash Wash. However, most inventions are not successful, and Bill's experience is not typical of what inventors can expect.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-260-7793. That's 1-800-260-7793.
I've fallen and I can't get up. I need help.
When you are home alone and have a bad fall where you cannot move, you are stuck in a very limited area. If you cannot reach a phone, you may lay helpless on the floor for hours or days, which can result in permanent incapacitation or death.
This waterproof pennant is my magic wand. To some of the paramedics, fire department, police, or my doctor, it contacts Life Alert.
When you have a heart attack like I did, and there's no one there, Life Alert was there for me. I couldn't handle the alternative of going to a nursing home.
Thanks to Life Alert, you can live alone without ever being alone. And that's why I wear one.
New Life Alert Classic for seniors or Life Alert 50 Plus.
Please call 1-800-586-0025 for a free brochure about Life Alert. That's 1-800-586-0025. Call us toll free now at 1-800-586-0025. That number again, 1-800-586-0025.
A judge has tossed out a lawsuit by a former New York City firefighter. Timothy Brown was trying to stop the building of a mosque near the World Trade Center. The judge ruled Brown had no legal standing to bring the suit. Critics say the project is an insult to victims of the 9/11 attacks. A lawyer for the developer calls it a, quote, victory for America.
Have you ever wondered what it's like to walk the coast of Israel? Veteran NBC correspondent Martin Fletcher did just that and discovered an Israel he never knew. Here's CBN News' Chris Mitchell with that story.
Living in Israel for 30 years, NBC's Martin Fletcher has covered wars, disasters, and other events throughout the Middle East. He assigned himself, however, to walk the entire coast of Israel, along the Mediterranean Sea, from Lebanon to the Gaza Strip, where more than 70% of Israelis live.
I started up there and I finished down there.
Fletcher gives his step-by-step account, walking Israel, a personal search for the soul of a nation.
I had a very clear goal in mind when I wrote the book. I wanted to show it's a great place that makes tremendous contributions to the world, that has tremendous problems that need to be solved very urgently, but We don't need to focus only on the problems. We should focus also on the good things about Israel.
Like many Israeli residents, Fletcher hears the same questions.
So many people used to call me up and say, hey, is it safe to visit Israel? And I say, yeah, of course it is. And they call me back a week later after they arrived and say, wow, it's a great place. I had no idea. And I wanted to write a book about that great place about which people so often don't have any idea.
Fletcher wanted to reveal a side of Israel most people don't see, because the media usually tells a one-sided story.
We present a country that's always in conflict, and therefore the story of Israel is the war, the brutality, the occupation, the Jewish settlers, the fighting, the bombs, the killing. That's the Israel the world knows.
But he says there's much more.
But anybody who's spent time here realizes mostly it's a very peaceful, wonderful country. And that peaceful, wonderful country rarely gets shown. And that's what I wanted to do with the book, to show that peaceful, wonderful place.
Fletcher believes Israel has gotten a raw deal in the world.
I think Israel is the only country in the world that whose very existence is in question. Its right to exist is in question. I mean, nobody says about Zimbabwe or North Korea, hey, should that country exist? Israel is the only country in the world that people say, should that country exist? Israel has a right to exist. And I love the country personally, and I was hoping to show in the book that it is a great place that should continue to exist. It's got terrible problems that need to be solved, but this process of delegitimization of Israel that is taking hold in some parts of the world, in some parts of Europe especially, I think is wrong.
For Christians, it shows another side of the Holy Land.
So I think for Christians who come here mostly to the Holy Land and to follow in the footsteps of Jesus and all those wonderful history and reality of the place that they follow, I think to understand the context of that story too, in modern terms, to know Israel as it is today, I think it helps you understand the past.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, on the Israeli coast.
Up next, one minute it was a sunny day in Northern Virginia, and the next minute it was anything but. See what happened to this couple and how it changed their lives and their careers.
What makes the miracles of Jesus even more miraculous? Standing where they happened, in Israel. Come explore Jerusalem, where Jesus opened blind eyes. Visit the hills of Galilee, where Jesus fed the multitude. Stroll through Capernaum, where Jesus lived and taught and healed. To learn more about standing where it all happened, in Israel, visit www.goisrael.com. Come visit Israel.
Are you anxious to protect your family with life insurance, but afraid you can't afford it? Well, look how much insurance many people can get through SelectQuote for less than a dollar a day. SelectQuote found Rich, 37, a $500,000 policy for under $18 a month. Even though Dave, 43, takes meds to control his blood pressure, SelectQuote got him a $500,000 policy for under $28 a month. Ellen, 47, got a $250,000 policy for under $20 a month. All it takes is a phone call. Your personal SelectQuote agent will answer all your questions and impartially shop the highly rated term life companies SelectQuote represents for your best rates. Give your family the security it needs at a price you can afford. Call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote, we shop, you save.
What makes the miracles of Jesus even more miraculous? Standing where they happened, in Israel. Come visit Capernaum, where Jesus restored a paralytic's helpless legs. Sail the Sea of Galilee, where Jesus walked on the water. Stroll through the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus healed a servant's ear. To learn more about standing where it all happened, in Israel, visit www.goisrael.com. Come visit Israel.
Alabama has seen more EF5 tornadoes than any other state. The National Weather Service upgraded a tornado which hit Alabama this past April to an EF5. the strongest tornado on the enhanced Fujita scale. That means Alabama has seen 7 EF5 tornadoes since 1950, when the Weather Service began keeping records. The reclassified Twister was one of 2 EF5 storms in a swarm of more than 60 tornadoes that hit Alabama on April 27th. 240 people died. Texas, Oklahoma, Iowa, and Kansas have seen 6 EF5 tornadoes since 1950.
Well, we've seen deadly twisters throughout the Midwest and parts of the Southeast already this year.
Now the National Hurricane Center predicts we could see up to 6 major hurricanes this season. As Ephraim Graham reports, extreme weather has some people seeking shelter underground.
Storm chasers captured these amazing images of twisters whipping through Iowa back in 2004. The same year, Steve and Cindy Willis recorded a storm many states away from Tornado Alley.
Yeah, it was very scary.
Yeah, it was.
At her mom's house in Northern Virginia.
My daughter called and says, Mom, I just want to let you know that Caroline County's under a tornado watch. And we totally blew her off. We're like, ah, whatever.
Just after all the hurricanes had come through, and it was a sunny day, but there were clouds.
So my mom and I are sitting on the back porch, and I start hearing this really strange sound. And it sounded like helicopter blades, you know, wah, 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 wah.
My wife went outside and started looking around.
My father comes out at that point, and he also hears the noise. So he walks to the end of the driveway so he can see around that last pine tree and starts screaming, it's a tornado, get underneath the house.
They were yelling for me. I went outside, and the first thing I see is a tree flying over my head. So at that point, I knew something was horribly wrong.
Next thing you know, we're under the house. Steve has finally joined us and is holding the crawl space door so he could see out. And the tornado was coming up the driveway.
It was snapping trees coming down the driveway and just shooting them down the driveway like missiles.
This is what they saw when they came out moments later.
Oh, her car got wasted, man.
National Weather Service investigators told Steve and Cindy that not one, but 2 twisters flattened the garage, flipped a trailer, and shook up their lives.
What happened after that experience is every spring and summer when tornado season would roll around, we would just feel anxious. You know, what if we had to relive a tornadic event again?
After 3 years of living in fear of how their family would survive another severe storm, Steve and Cindy installed this underground storm shelter. It is 10 feet by 6 feet and can hold up to 12 people.
We have a weather radio, so if the weather radio goes off and it's a warning, which we take serious now, we will immediately go to our shelter, and it is such peace of mind.
That feeling of security inspired the Willises to go into the business of safety. Steve, a licensed contractor, and Cindy, working in finance, now market, sell, and install storm shelters.
I guess the hope is, of course, you'll never need it, but you will. We've had ours in the ground for 4 years, and we've been in ours a number of times.
Business is up. Like storm shelter companies in the Midwest, the Willises saw an increase after spring twisters in unexpected places, like Gloucester County, Virginia.
Really, since Alabama, North Carolina, and Deltaville specifically, you know, I think we fielded over 1,000 calls in 30 to 40 days.
Government plans for community storm shelters are also on the drawing board. About 50 are slated for southern Mississippi. Chilton County, Alabama has 5 and is adding 3. In Missouri, 25 schools are planning for shelters. And in Tulsa, Oklahoma, a school district is rebuilding a 150-person safe room.
I will acknowledge, you know, that the shelters are not a small ticket purchase.
The smallest underground fiberglass shelter in the Willis's shop costs about $7,000.
You cannot put a price tag on safety, and it is worth every penny we spent.
The shelter has given this husband and wife peace of mind, and it may have inspired the career goals of their 10-year-old son, Derek.
He has become quite fascinated with severe weather.
His dream is to become a meteorologist and a storm chaser, yeah.
He could soon be racing toward the storm, just as mom and dad take shelter away from it. Ephraim Graham, CBN News, Ruther Glen, Virginia.
Coming up, why this restaurant owner would ban children from eating at his restaurant.
Millions of women worldwide love Bare Minerals.
This is smooth, it's nice, and it covers. I like that.
Only Bare Minerals looks like beautiful bare skin, while it covers whatever you want it to. And now you can get our latest kit with our totally new, totally spill-proof Click Lock Go Foundation. For over 75% off retail, our new kit comes with Bare Minerals Foundation in the shade that's just right for you. Warmth for a healthy glow. Mineral Veil, the ultimate finishing touch, and Bare Minerals Flawless Application Brush. Call now and get three full-size gifts worth $57.95 free. Purchased separately, you'd spend over $120. Our original Get Started Kit was a great deal at two payments of $29.99. But now you can get all this for just one payment of $29.99. Save over $90 and get a 30-day money-back guarantee.
Call 1-800-376-4174. Ask how you can receive this handy compact. Call 1-800-376-4174 now.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding. You don't have to prick your fingers. And some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
Thanks for staying with us. You've probably experienced it. You're sitting at a restaurant trying to enjoy your dinner, but a loud child just keeps on whining and crying.
Well, while most people expect that circumstance, one Pennsylvania restaurant owner is putting his foot down and saying, no more kids. Mike Viewick has decided to ban any child under the age of 6 from eating at his restaurant, McDane's. He says kids under that age are just too noisy. And while many customers say kids in the restaurant don't bother them, the owner says he has the right to deny service to them.
Nothing wrong with babies, but the fact is you can't control their volume. And there may be restaurants that prefer to cater to such things. Not here. I think it's the height of being impolite and selfish, and so therefore I instituted the policy.
It was an ignorant decision. Who says that at 6 you're magically mature enough to eat in a restaurant?
McDane's is a small restaurant that only seats 40 people. It's nestled on a golf course and typically serves an older clientele. Viewick says he's imposing the rules so that those customers will no longer be bothered while eating.
It'll be interesting to see how it affects his business. Yeah. Doesn't sound like it will too much because of where it's located and who it primarily serves. That's all for this edition of CBN News Midday. Thanks for watching.
Have a great day, everyone. See you tomorrow.
Are you anxious to protect your family with life insurance, but afraid you can't afford it? Well, look how much insurance many people can get through SelectQuote for less than a dollar a day. SelectQuote found Rich, 37, a $500,000 policy for under $18 a month. Even though Dave, 43, takes meds to control his blood pressure, SelectQuote got him a $500,000 policy for under $28 a month. Ellen, 47, got a $250,000 policy for under $20 a month. All it takes is a phone call. Your personal SelectQuote agent will answer all your questions and impartially shop the highly rated term life companies SelectQuote represents for your best rates. Give your family the security it needs at a price you can afford. Call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote, we shop, you save.
Life can be tough. There are challenges for all of us. Jesus told us to pray for one another, and that's exactly what we want to do. On 700 Club Interactive, we use technology to bring Christians together to pray for each other. Meet others just like you, and talk or share with them in real time. Watch God work miracles in people's lives. Be part of 700 Club Interactive, weekdays at 11 a.m. on CBN.com.